Hi guys, I'm Chris from Viking Ventures. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be doing a direct comparison of the Suzuki Gsxs1000GX and the BMW S1000XR, just to see how well it stacks up. I've got high hopes for the GX, to be honest, but the S1000XR is a formidable foe. So we'll do a direct comparison against the two. I've just literally just posted a review of the GX and I absolutely loved it. So I'm just gonna go into a bit of detail on as to whether or not it's worth the extra money, because obviously the S1000XR in the same spec as the GX is about £4,000 different. So ultimately we're just going to just try and find out whether or not it's £4,000 better. But if you do find yourself coming back to the channel, I would really appreciate if you could hit that like and subscribe button, as that obviously helps the channel to grow and I can just keep pumping out content, decent, honest content for you. So we'll roll the intro and I'll catch back once it's done. Cheers. The lovely S1000XR, look at it. It is a nice bike, isn't it? I think it's one of the better looking bikes that that BMW produce, to be fair. I do like all the styling. Lights, really nice. Nice looking bike. Fully adjustable windscreen on the front, which is a welcomed addition on bikes like these, because I definitely know that on the GX it's not adjustable. You've got to unbolt it and fasten it back. So I think equipment wise, I think this bike is going to be better equipped. The finish quality of it, actually, it does seem to be quite good. The brakes, I'm not sure if it's just a particular model that I was on the GX, but the brakes did not feel overly confident. I think that could just be a case of it just needing to be bled. Just the master cylinder, it was just a serious lack of feel. The brakes on this, just with the short ride that I've had so far, are absolutely amazing. Really, really good. Clutch is quite grabby, as you'd expect from a BMW, but once you get on the road and stuff, it is very easy to come to terms with. The ride is quite stiff, that is probably going to be one of the major differences between this bike and the GX, is going to be the overall comfort. Because if you look at this, that seat, there's no meat. It's just, what is that? BMWs and their seats. Don't get me wrong, it holds you nicely. It definitely cradles the buttocks nicely. Like two people with their hands out and you're just literally putting your bum in them, but I would definitely say the GX would 100% take it for comfort. I do like the riding position. I think it's very similar to the GX, if not pretty much identical. I'm not experiencing any excessive leaning on the bike. It's not trying to pull me forward, anything like that. It is a really, really nice riding position. The bike did feel light, not quite as light as the GX though, I will say. The GX definitely does feel a lighter machine once you're moving than this does. What else am I going to touch on here? The overall finish quality, 17, just shy of 18 grand. The gearbox feels nice and smooth. You operating in the gearbox feels very nice and smooth, very precise. I don't think it's quite as smooth as the GX. The quick shifter is very instant, quite stiff, definitely not as smooth as the GX. The turning speed, just with the short ride to get to where I am now, it didn't feel quite as eager as the GX either. I mean, don't get me wrong, this is an awesome machine. I think a little bit more sports orientated than what the GX is going to be, but I think ultimately the GX is going to be a more rounded machine. This also comes with the BMW warranty. This is on loan from Lloyds in Carlisle, which in my opinion is probably one of the better branches that I've visited and I've had dealings with. They're very, very useful, very helpful. But yeah, I do like this bike. I think it looks stunning. I think it'd probably look a bit better without these bloody things on the front here. What is that even for? Yeah, I do like it. I do like it. The engine's nice and pert and wanting. It's definitely got a lot of power. I think it's like 160 horsepower. You know, so it's not a great deal more than the GX. I think it produces a bit more torque. It's this is. I think it's going to be tight. I think it's going to be really tight. At the minute, though, from where I'm standing, I would still prefer to have the GX because I just think it feels a lighter, smoother experience, you know. But if you want the thrills and you want to ride, then it will definitely deliver. This obviously comes with all the bells and whistles, you know, so we'll just power this on. Got the typical BMW dash. Very familiar experience, these, you know, whatever BMW bike that you come off in the past 3 or 4 or 5 years, you know, you're going to have a very similar experience. You've got your different rider modes. You know, you can hit this button here. I've got it in dynamic mode because I don't really like it in anything else, but just to cycle through, you've got dynamic, you've got rain, road, and back to dynamic again. So I'll leave that in that. You've got three settings for your heated grips. You've got 1, 2, and 3, or 3, 2, 1, as they say. So they just show you that working. So that's 3, 2, 1. Automatic daytime running lights. We've got all your different suspension settings that can be adjusted here. So if we press this, I've got it set to dynamics. I do like a bit of a firmer ride, but you can change it to road, which in my previous experience has always been a little bit too soft for me. So do you know what I'll do? I'll actually leave that in road, and we'll see when we get on the road just how well that stacks up against some of the older bikes that I've had experience on. We've got your typical cruise control, you know, on, slide right to on. So we'll turn that on. And then that's off, and then you've got your trim settings there on this little set thing here. Sorry about the camera angle. Typical menu button, you know, we can scroll through all the different menus. You've got your BMW toggle wheel to go through the typical settings. You know, as you know, I'm not a big fan of all of the electronics on bikes these days. I think it just takes away from the riding experience. But you've got a little cubby hole there, which they did suggest you could put your phone in. I mean, I don't even think the camera would even fit in there, to be fair, never alone a phone. But yeah, keyless ride. I like the keyless ride. I think it's a much needed thing on bikes, because you got all of those bike thefts going on abroad and over here and stuff like that. I suppose it stops people from just pulling up and just robbing your keys. We've got a baby DIN port here. You can get converters for these. You can directly change it to USB, or you can get an actual DIN converter which just plugs in. I had one of those on my F800 and on the 1200, to be fair, but in the end I ended up just swapping it out for just for a normal USB. But what we'll do is we'll get on this bike and we'll ride it, because ultimately at the end of the day it's all about how does this bike ride. So I'll get on it and we'll get on the road, and then we'll start testing. So I'll catch you up then. Right, let's get sorted out and get on bike. Been looking forward to this for a while, to be honest.
supposed to be a beast. Can't believe how thin this seat is. It's ridiculous. This is slightly lowered, this bike as well, so it is quite small for me. Just get off of this muddy ground. Throttle response is nice. Now we have got it set into road mode, so we see what that feels like. It still feels quite plush, to be fair, which is I'm quite happy about that. Still quite a firm ride. Definitely not as comfortable as the GX. I could 100% say that. Switch gear is nice to use. Easy to get access to. Quick shifter is lovely and smooth, don't get me wrong, but I just found the transition between gears to be much smoother on the GX. You know, I mean, I don't want to hammer this bike too hard. I mean, this has been around for a while and the GX is brand new, but I'd expected over the years to for that BMW would have refined some of these things, to be honest. And it's a lovely day. It's currently 10 degrees. Should have brought my shorts. But yeah, this is where I brought the GS up here. I mean, the brakes on this thing are absolutely phenomenal. Really, really good. Really good. You got instant response from the front end. Gearbox is still relatively stiff, even on the downshift it's quite stiff. Just give it a bit of a poke up here. Whoa, yeah, okay. That's got a bit of meat to it. I feel slightly more, only slightly more power than the GX. And I think it's like 8 horsepower difference, and I mean, this bike definitely is not as agile as the GX either. But you could still have loads of fun. You can still do track days on bikes like this. Easy. You know, the GX might be slightly lighter. It definitely feels more nimble, more agile, more eager to turn into a corner, as this seems to want to stay upright. Yeah, it's fun, this is fun. And, you know, let's face it, you know, a lot of people do comment on the speed and stuff, but ultimately what I'm doing is I'm testing the bike, you know, from my own experience, and to share that experience with you guys, you know, online on YouTube. You know, so I don't just want to dawdle around at 30 mile an hour all the time, although I do try and respect the speed limits as much as possible. You know, I want to get a good feel to see what this bike is actually like. Bit of wheelie there in third. Yeah, this is a fun bike. This is definitely a fun bike. Nice wide handlebars. No excessive, well, there is a little bit of vibration through the handlebars, but I mean through the mirrors, sorry. But yeah, it's nothing, you know, major. I'd say a little bit more vibe. I'm feeling a lot of vibes through the foot pegs. Through the backs of my bomb, obviously through my hands, through the handlebars, and we'll try that at different rev ranges and to see if that just calms down a little bit, or if it does actually get worse. No, it definitely gets worse. Quick shifter and auto blipper, as I've mentioned, is, you know, it is smooth. It's very precise. It's eager. This bike is very eager. Everything about it You know, it wants you to push on. It'll quite happily sit at you know, normal cruising speeds, you know, just pottering around. But I think ultimately this bike wants to be ridden hard. Yeah. But I'm enjoying this. When you're on the bike and you're moving, the bike does feel quite nimble. Let me just try the brakes out quickly. Okay, the brakes are exceptionally good. Really good. It's just what I expected, to be fair, from a BMW. Unless you're on a GS1250. And I've still got the suspension set in road mode. I'm not feeling any need to change from that. I know we've got dynamic mode as well, and it's, you know, in dynamic mode they say, oh, you can feel the suspension working underneath. You can't feel frig all. Nothing. I've never had a bike where it actually felt, apart from that, this is going to sound ridiculous, this, the GX felt like as if there was a difference, but that didn't have a dynamic mode. It did have an auto preload on the back end of the bike, but it certainly did not by any measure. Oh, poor bunny rabbit. Sorry, distracted. It definitely didn't feel as if it was automatically adjusting itself to the road condition. And thank you. I've ridden so many BMWs now, and they all say, oh, dynamic suspension this and dynamic suspension that, and some people might be able to feel it and might be able to vouch for it. I can't. That's all I'm saying. It's just one man's opinion, but I've ridden a lot of BMWs, a lot, and I do like to ride them hard. I like to ride all bikes hard. I'm not very lenient on them. And I would have thought that in my years of experience that I would have felt something from being, you know, from BMW suspension setup, especially the dynamically adjustable suspension, you know, something working. There is, I can't feel anything. I'm not sure if it's just that good that you're not supposed to feel anything. I don't know, but. Yeah, I certainly can't. Certainly can't. But this is a properly fun bike. Really fun. I'm not too sure about this seat. I like the fact that it cradles your bum. I like that. I can feel a lot of vibration through it. I think this could potentially be an issue, like on a long run or a long day in the saddle. It's kind of lacking a bit of padding. So I would definitely, the GX has a flawless victory against this bike when it comes to rider comfort and suspension up to now, for me and for me only. You know, you ride each of these bikes and you make up your own mind as to which one is better for you. But, you know, as I say, I do like to ride my bikes. I do like to do a bit of distance, and this rides perfectly nice. It's very, very good for what it is. I felt like the GX is definitely stepping ahead here. One area where it definitely is not, though, is the braking, because the brakes on this thing are awesome. And the another thing that I would like to touch on is the torque delivery on this engine. Let's just get the revs right the way down. Let's just have a quick play here. Let's just see how this feels in comparison, because I had the GX in sixth gear at 2000 RPM. So that's full throttle. I mean, you've got plenty of torque there. For an inline four, it's actually quite impressive just how torquey this engine is. While I'm saying that, I was in fourth gear. I mean, let's face it, these engines aren't, you know, designed to have huge portions of torque. You know, they are an adventure sports bike. You know, you can go adventuring around on, mainly on the roads. Well, I say mainly, all on the roads. And get the same, well, relatively the same performance out of a sports bike in a more upright seating position, which is why it's attractive to me, because I, you know, snapped my wrist, can't really ride sports bikes anymore, you know, so ideally these bikes are perfectly designed for somebody like me. I'm not saying that you have to be disabled to ride a bike like this, that is definitely not what I'm saying. See, I'm trying to get my my mate Big Mike to come on the channel. He's a very experienced, very fast rider. And it's just, he only rides sports bikes, you know, so I'm just trying to get him to, you know, have a go on one of these. But every time I mention it to him, he says, I'm not old enough. So let's just power and torque delivery again. Oh yeah, when you get it up to 8,000 RPM, you definitely feel a bit of a boost in power. Enough for speed and power for now. Let's just wind ourselves. Let's just calm, relax. Go a bit zen for a minute. Right, so how well does this bike like to behave itself at slower speeds? So if you're just if you're an elderly gentleman wanting to look cool and thought you'd buy yourself an S1000XR, you know, can it ride like a granddad? Is basically what I'm trying to say. Can it do that? And does it like doing that? It's very smooth. Very smooth, and it doesn't even bat an eyelid. Throttle response is still nice and clean. Very sharp. You know, there is a bit of throttle input there. You can see how much I'm twisting my hand there. It's lovely. It is lovely. I mean, seriously, I mean, I'm being seriously critical of both bikes in order to compare them, because they are both exceptional. And obviously the S1000XR and the Multistrada have been the top of this tree for a long, long time. They both do an excellent job. But now the Japanese are starting to get a little bit more, we want a bit of that. We can do better than that. Yeah, GX is absolutely incredible. You know, I'm not paid, but I'm not sponsored by anybody. This is just a proper, honest opinion. Like, if it was rubbish, I would honestly tell you. There is no way that I would just gloss over something for the benefit of the dealership or for the benefit of the manufacturer. And obviously, a review is just one person's opinion, you know, so ultimately, if you're looking at any of these, any bike, doesn't even matter if it's a 50cc moped, get out there, get on it, get a test ride on it, make sure it's right for you, because obviously every bike is different. I also want to say thank you very much to my subscribers at the moment. I know my subscribers are they're going up, and I massively appreciate that. You know, obviously this channel is absolutely nothing without you guys. From the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to just, it literally takes what, a second, just hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, you know, leave a comment. You know, if you ride one of these bikes, you're interested in one of these bikes, I will always respond to the comments. I don't shy away from anything, I don't ignore yous, even the bad ones. I like a bit of constructive criticism as well, so if there's anything that you think that I can do better, by all means, please, please, please do let me know, because obviously I want this to be a channel for the people, you know, as a biker, for bikers. As I say, a massive fan of 44 teeth and Teapot 1 and Lamb Chop Rides, you know, all of the main boys. and the, yeah, it's kind of watching their videos and riding all the bikes that I've ridden that's kind of, you know, it encouraged me to do this, to be fair. Because whereas I think they're excellent at doing bike reviews, they're all a bit old. I want to say old, I don't think Chris and Al are that old, but yeah, they're a damn sight a lot older than me. And I'd love to do a video with them, you know, at some point. When I get a little bit more experience behind me, get a little bit less camera shy, because I still get a little bit nervous when I'm on camera. So, Nationals. Yeah, that vibration doesn't seem to go away. I'm not sure, it could be just due to the tyres. I don't know. But there's a lot of vibration on this bike. I think it's just because, you know, obviously the last bike I rode was the GX and it was absolute silken. So silky smooth. And the power, I mean, the power is fun. It was an exciting bike to ride. It doesn't have quite as much power as this. Not of that. I mean, I didn't wring its neck too much. You know, not as much as I have done with this, because I literally just wanted to just feel, you know, you know when something's got a bit more poke. You know, you can instantly feel it. And this just felt as if it just had slightly bigger balls. Just slightly. A bit more girth to them. I'll tell you what, I would love to do this on a dry day. See, this is a problem, you see, is you try and behave yourself and then they throw roads like this at you. But no, must behave. But yeah, you see, when you under load on the throttle, I've immediately noticed the difference between the agility on the bike. This is going to be very similar to the Kawasaki Versys, I think, in the way that it doesn't want you, it kind of wants to stabilise you by lifting the bike back up under throttle. So I'll do this little test again just down here, and I want to see if you can see it. If you can't see it, say, Chris, you're full of crap, mate, move on, do something else. But so basically what I'm going to do is I'm just going to roll down to 30. Come on, get down to 30. Right, so maneuver the bike. Actually, there's a couple of cars behind me. I'll save doing this. Actually, I'll turn around here and then we'll go back the other way. I liked that little stretch of road, that was pretty cool. I don't know why there's not more young people out on bikes. It's doing me head in. Every time I'm out, I'm frigging, you know, out with granddad and sons. It's right, so it's a national speed limit, so I just bring the speed up a little bit. Right, so this is a test I'm on about. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna roll off the power enough where I'm not slowing down, but I'm not speeding up, and then I'm gonna tilt and tip the bike around. Let's get onto this bit of straight road. Right, and then, so I'm gonna keep on tipping it, and then I'm gonna accelerate, and you'll feel I'm fighting the bike to maneuver it. I'm not sure if you've seen that then, but enough for me to mention it. Otherwise I wouldn't. Well, I mean, let's face it, this is an S1000RR engine, which has been slightly detuned. And yeah, I have an S1000RR, and it is, I mean, that is, it's 204 horsepower at the back wheel, HP4, it's an absolute monster. Poor bloody thing, as I say, is just collecting dust in my garage. Can't ride the thing. Spent an absolute fortune on it. and it'll still be there in the next 10 years time, because I don't think I'll ever part with it, but I just love it. One of my favourite bikes of all time. You know, so this has got some serious performance orientated engineering going on. Serious. Come on, you bloody dick squeezer. But yeah, the torque is very impressive. Very impressive. Don't get me wrong, this is I'm testing a bike. I don't ride like this all the time, but you know, I want to make sure that I can give the best opinion that I can possibly can on what it's like to ride this this machine. And unfortunately, I've only got this bike for a couple of hours. I would always recommend people to test ride a bike for a full day, because you can't really experience what life is going to be like with any bike in a couple of hours. You just can't. And I think, you know, once you've you know, got on a bike and you've got all the electronics on there and it's wow, this is amazing, you know, and then the honeymoon period, you know, kind of ends and you're left a little bit dull-witted, because you know, the glitz and the glamour's all worn off and you're now left with a potentially, you know, an £18,000 bike, which you could have got the same experience for £4,000 less. I can definitely say at the moment that I would, if somebody was to put this bike and the GX in front of me and I had to pick, it would still be the GX, because I still get that thrill of the ride. I find the handling superior. Yeah, fair enough, that front brake was a bit on the crap side, but I'm sure something could be done about that. That wouldn't be enough to put me off the bike. The switch gear, the quality of the switch gear on this bike feels slightly superior, although that also wouldn't be enough to put me off buying the bike, because ultimately the reason we buy a bike is because we like it and it's how it rides. You know, you've got to make a compromise between the things you want and the things you need, and there's got to be a nice line between the middle, and you want a bike which is going to pretty much tick, you know, most of the boxes on each, in each category. You know, even if you've got to compromise looks, you know, to get like a decent ride out of the bike, you know, a little bit of power to get a nice smoother power delivery, and a nicer gearbox, so to say, you know, because you're going to get more enjoyment out of riding that particular bike. And I'm not going to take away from this bike that this is amazing. This really is a lovely bike, and yeah, I couldn't imagine anybody having any real complaints about owning one other than this friggin' seat. I've only been on this bike for, well, what, 40 minutes? And I'm already starting to get a little bit, I wouldn't say achy, but I can feel my ass. You know, I definitely know that it's there. So, you know, a few hours more in this seat, there's going to be a lot of whinging going on. This is even more uncomfortable than the Ducati comfort seat for the Multistrada, and that is saying something. Because I brought that seat and it was absolutely horrific. I can't even believe it's even called a comfort seat. It is diabolically bad. The one I've got at the minute is the Touratech one, which is slightly firmer than the standard seat, but yeah, that's the Ducati, we're not talking about that. Yeah, would I mean, as I said previous video, had I not brought my Multistrada, I probably would have brought the GX, because it is that good. And I just think, for you're saving yourself, don't get me wrong, the stock version of this bike I think is about 15.5-16 grand. I'll put it up on screen if I'm wrong. You know, which is, it's not huge amounts you know, more money than the GX in standard form. But the only problem is that you then don't get the BMW Gear Shift Assist Pro. You know, you don't get your lights, and there's a few other little glitzy bits. I'll probably put that on screen as well, because otherwise somebody will whinge. So for the same spec for spec, as close as I could possibly get it, it was the absolute standard GX, Gsxs1000GX, and you've got the S1000XR. Both exact, as I say, as close to specs as I could possibly get. The GX is 14 grand, just over 14 grand, and the XR was the shy of 18 grand. So ultimately, you're saving yourself almost the best part of nearly 4 grand for the same experience. The only difference is you've not got the BMW badge on the side of it. You've got, if you go to Yule's, and as I say, I'm not sponsored by Yule's or anything, it's just my personal experience through Yule's. If you go to Yule's, you will get a 7-year main component warranty with the bike, and then you'll get a lifetime warranty, which I think you'll have to go onto their website and look at what that includes. I know it includes a hell of a lot of stuff. A lot more, you know, warranty and you know, they actually looking to look after you for as long as humanly possible. You do not get that with this, and I can speaking from experience, not just from myself but from one of my brothers as well, BMW do not like to look after you. I know a lot of people have had some brilliant experiences with BMW. I am not one of them. It's the BMW breakdown assist, the BMW extended warranty doesn't even cover you for engine components, for, you know, for clutch gearbox issues, suspension issues. Once your initial period has expired, that's it. Even if you extend the warranty. Now, I could be mistaken about this, but they just don't offer you the same as what Suzuki or Yule's do for a better word. It's you know, Suzuki themselves only offer 3 years, but Yule's 7 years, and then you get a lifetime warranty on top of that for other bits of the bike. Obviously it's a Suzuki, you know, so it's going to run. Yeah, that is another factor to take into consideration, you know, when you're buying a new bike. Yeah, definitely worthwhile to look into that. Right, back down to Blackford. It is literally just like, it feels like you're riding a sports bike, this bike. You've got that power that you're looking for. I've got to say, I do prefer the sound of the GX. It did give a better exhaust note from that stock exhaust. Whereas this sounds typically BMW. I know it's all governed by Euro 5 and all that jazz, but you know, you have to whip that thing off and get a full system on it. Nothing obnoxious, but oh, poor bunny rabbit. Could probably take that home and eat it. Nah, don't be silly. But yeah, so my experience on this so far has been fun. I have enjoyed this. Would it make a decent long distance bike? I think it has the potential. I know the fuel consumption is around, it's between 38 and 42 mpg. Just let me see if I can pull that up. Probably not whilst going around a bend. There's sports clocks and stuff. That's so sexual. Let's go down. So let's have a quick look. That should give us an average consumption of 44.1, so it's do you know what, it's actually slightly better than what I recorded on the GX, and I found the fuel in to be absolutely perfect. Yeah, this does feel exceptional, this bike. But I'm still sticking to what I said. I would still prefer to have the GX. Because that little bit of extra power just isn't worth it to me. I think if you've got the GX full system, you know, it's actually sounded like a Gsxr as well. It'd be awesome. Awesome, decent fuel, get a decent remap on it. You know, you'd be putting out more power than one of these. And obviously then you've got the comfort that comes with it. You've got the better ride from the suspension. Don't get me wrong, it's not as good to shock setup and the brakes aren't as good and all that sort of stuff, but you know, that's by the by. It's how the bike rides. And ultimately what this bike was designed for, and this bike was designed to go long distances very quickly. Same as the GX was, but the GX will do it in so much more comfort. Another thing that I will touch on as well is the wind protection for my leggies. It doesn't have quite as much leg wind protection as the GX. This does come with a better standard screen. I think I might have touched on this already. Handguards seem to be in a nice position, keeping the cool air off my hands, although you can't feel anything with these get big thick buggers on. Just open the old visor. I'm getting a bit stuffy in there, but yeah, thank you very much to Lloyd's BMW for loaning me the bike. Oh, bit of a dodgy shift there from the auto shifter, quick shifter, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, as I say, brilliant dealership. You know, if you live up this end, this neck of the woods, I'd definitely try your hardest to stay away from Bowker in Preston. Absolute hideous company. Definitely not one of the best dealerships that I've been to. Cost me a lot of money. But yeah, Lloyd's Motorrad, brilliant. Everyone's super helpful. They're dead sharp. You know, if you've got an appointment for your bike, you know, there's no messing around. Drop the bike off, it's always done within the allotted time slot that they give you. No hassle. You know, a lot of them, funny enough, a lot of the people there though don't actually own a BMW. Weird that, isn't it? You know, you expect a bike dealership, everybody rides BMWs or Ducatis or Hondas or whatever else, but yeah. Each their own, as they say. Each their own. And at the end of the day, big family of bikers, so it doesn't matter what you ride. Man on a scooter, tip the old head to him, got a wave. Oh yes. Oh yes. Nodded to a bloke on a 125 the other day. Didn't nod, didn't wave or nothing. Honestly, I was fuming. Felt like turning around and chasing after him and road rashing him off his frigging scooter. 125, whatever the hell it was. Yeah, I've really enjoyed this. Really enjoyed it. Quality machine. Quality. Very easy to get into neutral. And clutch is nice and light. As I say, it's just, I don't know what it is about BMWs. It's usually quite sharp. You know, just as you're letting the clutch out, the biting point's like really close. And I usually like it to be quite, you know, much more towards the top of the clutch lever. But yeah, these brakes, phenomenal. Obviously, this comes with adjustable levers. You know, so if you've got tiny little mitts, you know, you can make these fit you. But yeah, lovely experience. Engine's quite noisy. I'm hearing a lot of sounds like a cam chain rattle or something. That's the only way that I could describe it. I know it'd be foolish to think it'd be the cam chain on a bike as new as this, but it definitely it's the only thing that I can say that describes what I'm hearing. It definitely sounds like a cam chain. Brilliant engine though, these BMW motors. Brilliant engines. I think with a decent, you got a pipe on this thing. Sound awesome. Awesome. But yeah, trying to get more young people out on bikes is hard these days. You know, just get them interested in bikes. Now, whenever I speak to, you know, anyone under the age of 20 about bikes, they're either absolutely smitten with them, or they couldn't think of doing anything worse. Bikes are so dangerous. It all comes down to the rider. You know, and you've got to be super sharp. You know, treat everybody on the road as if they're aiming for you. And you can't go far wrong with that. Just keep your wits about you, because there's blind spots in cars and all that sort of stuff. You know, they can't always see you 100% of the time. But in saying that, you get a lot of penises on the road. You know, people wheeling past cars, you know, down dual carriageways and all that sort of stuff. Reason why our insurance is so expensive. But they're the sort of people that you don't want on a bike, because they make us all look bad. All of us look bad. Alright, so how do I get to this garage then? See how much this cost me to fill it up. I haven't done that many miles, to be honest, but I've used a bar. You know, I've only thrashed it a few times. Yeah, sunny Carlisle. Sunny Carlisle. There's Lloyd's. Revisiting move over you. Frig me. Let's see if I can sneak in here. Yeah, I gotta say, I do love the responsiveness of the brakes on this bike. The handling seems, you know, really, really nice. You know, it definitely, you know, when you're off the throttle, you know, it'll allow you to do and manoeuvre the bike however you see fit. But it's just when you're under load, you know, if you're coming to power out of a corner or something, you know, if the bend like carries on round and, you know, you're giving it some welly, you know, this bike is going to try and fight you. Which I never thought I'd experience that on a bike like this, because obviously I've watched tons of reviews on this bike and I haven't really heard of anybody mentioning that. I don't know why I've experienced it. Could this be this particular, which is why I might be leaning more towards the tyres, but... Right, well, I'm going to get some juice. Right, so, that was £4.13. For a morning squirt, that's not bad. I'd say they're pretty much about the same for fuel consumption between this and the GX. One thing that I will say is the throttle response in first gear between this and the GX is a little different as well. You know, like sometimes if you're in an inline four, you know, sports derived engine, all that sort of stuff, if you know, slow speed throttle control, this is more like an on and off switch if you're going very slowly, coming off the clutch and things like that. It's I think the GX is far more forgiving. This does feel a little snatchy. You know, but you have got, as I say, performance based engine in the bike, so it's not that I'm going to complain about it, it's just an observation. But yeah, the I really do mean it, the Suzuki is such a good bike, and I definitely would still pick the GX over this bike. You know, at the same time, I've saved myself $4,000, you know, buying an exhaust, you know, put a few glitzy bits on it, you know, probably get, you know, what, remap's about 450, 500 quid. You'll have more power, more torque, it's a smoother engine, it's more comfortable, the suspension feels nicer. I'm not going to say it's better, it just feels nicer from a rider's point of view. Probably put a bit of that money into the front brake, and you know, ultimately at the end of all that, you probably still saved yourself $2,500. You know, because you got to take into consideration that, you know, if you're saving money by buying a cheaper bike, but you've still got to pump money into it to make it feel or perform as good, then you're not really saving anything, are you? You know, so I still think that the GX would be the better purchase for me personally. So I have arrived at Lloyd's. If you have made it this far, thank you very much for watching my videos. I really do appreciate it and giving me the opportunity. Yeah, this has been the S1000XR. I'd still prefer the GX. And yeah, thank you very much. Ride safe out there, guys, and I will see you in the next video.